call
myself.
Me Monsi.
Okay, Monsi. No, not Super Diva. Oh, sometimes Monsi. Si. Once I say Monsi,
but
then...
But not Montserrat.
No.
Because
okay.
The very close friends say Monsi to
yeah,
me.
Yeah, yeah. But oh. If I say my Super Diva,
yeah,
my baby, my darling, all this, yes. You know.
I'm so nervous. I know, I'm so nervous.
Phoebe, there's an ashtray, huh?
Vamos ahora a hacer una entrevista a Montserrat Caballé y a Fred Mercury para Televisión Española.
It's already started. Yeah, one second.
¿Han empezado ya?
The sun's going in my...
Montserrat, cuando le ofrecieron grabar este disco, ¿conocía ya de antemano la obra de Freddy o se la mostraron entonces?
No, conozco la música de Freddy desde hace muchos años porque mis hijos son grandes adoradores de su música y de él, y en mi casa siempre ha sonado su voz y sus canciones, por lo tanto era familiar en mí el estilo y también la suave y al mismo tiempo imperativa melodía que él hace y posee. Y cuando me ofreció esto me pareció casi increíble. Y estuve muy emocionada de ello y encontré que la música era maravillosa. Cuando se sentó al piano y tocó para mí todas sus obras y todo lo que él piensa componer para nosotros, me pareció maravilloso, y sobre todo porque es un músico tan excelente y es un músico que en la composición realmente es maravilloso, es magnífico.
Freddy, in the interview did you in the weekly information, you said you like very much Montserrat Caballé. Was in that moment when you decided to make the record together, or the idea came beforehand?
Well, at that time, I mean, they asked me who was my favorite singer, and I said Monsi, you know, and I told them that I didn't say that just because I was in Barcelona, because it sounds corny. But then after that, I mean, it was like a dream come true. You know, it was like a dream at the time to actually, well, of course, I thought about it. I thought, I wonder if our voices would match or whether she would accept or anything. And I think the rumor went round from the record company and friends and everything, and I think she was approached or asked or whatever. And she said yes. It was just one of those things. And then I went, you know, I came to Barcelona to see her for the first time, and I played her a few tunes, and she liked it. Now she's rock and roller.
¿Cómo fue la propuesta para hacer esta canción, Montserrat?
Musical. Your proposal was a musical one.
Yes, yes, yes.
Y fue encantadora porque, como Freddy dice, vino a Barcelona y su música sonó, su melodía, su creación, y me cautivó completamente.
Freddy, what do you think this record is going to mean in your career?
Well, I mean, I don't know. At the moment, it's not out. I don't know what it's going to do to my career, but I know that as far as it might go completely down. I don't know.
Wow.
No. Well, no. I think it's just like a dream come true personally, you see. And I think it's going to. It means a lot to me because I've like finally done something that I really wanted, is to sing with her. And to me, it's like blown my mind, you know. And at the moment, I still don't believe it's happening. You know, I have to keep touching her that she's here. So I think career-wise, I mean, it really doesn't matter. I mean, I'm just so proud of the fact that I've actually done it, you know. Because I remember when we were actually like rehearsing and doing things, I still thought it's not happening. And finally, when she recorded, when she came to London to record, and I finally got her voice on tape, I thought, now that's it. I've got it, you know. And so then, now she can't run away. I got the voice, and I just hope there's some better things to come. You know, because we're going to sort of do some more things. This is just the first one, and wait till you listen to some of the other ones. We're working on them.
Montserrat, esta es la primera vez que usted graba un disco de este tipo,
sí.
De estas características. ¿Por qué?
En primer lugar, porque para grabar un disco de esta, podríamos decir, inspiración, se necesita con un background muy musical. Y solo una persona muy musical podía acercarse a mí. No es orgullo, pero sí es una constatación. Y yo puedo asegurarles que cuando Freddy se sienta al piano y comienza a improvisar la melodía que le nace y que crea, es maravilloso. Él me regaló la música de Vocalize of Love que yo canté en el Covent Garden de Londres el 29 de marzo y que el público inglés encontró que era una locura. Es su música que la rehizo para mí, para mi voz, y que la canté con una gran ilusión y verdaderamente tuvo un grandioso éxito en Covent Garden. A mí me parece que la creación de Freddy es de una música muy especial que nace del corazón, para el corazón. Yo creo que tal vez por esto ha llegado a mi corazón. Freddy, I think your music come from your heart. That's why it came to my heart.
Yes, well, it's emotional,
It is.
You were talking about
everything, your music, your creation, all the way through.
She embarrassed me to come and go, because then she announced me, and I was sitting there, you know, with my tuxedo and everything, and I had to stand up and take a bow, and she blew kisses at me, and I blew kisses back.
But the audience loved it. They went crazy at the Royal Opera House.
Freddy, before the rehearsals started, what was the thing that worries you the most?
Before what?
The rehearsals, well, about the record, or before you started really recording the record, what worries you the most about this record?
Well, nothing. I mean, I was just very excited, and I just wanted to make sure that everything turned out right. So I took a lot of time and pain over it, you know. I mean, it was like, because it's the first time I've actually written for, say, her voice and everything, because before, I mean, it's easier just to write for my voice, because I know. And so I had to sort of really sort of do trials, like I even sort of sang high, you know, trying to imitate her voice to see if it would fit.
You do it very well.
Yes, indeed. Sometimes she said it was quite good. And so it's sort of, it's a different approach, you know, so I mean, it's, like it was risky because I mean I didn't quite know whether she would like it or not, and so we had to sort of just hope that she would like. But she changed a few things, you know. It wasn't like that she had to sing everything I said. And the thing I want in the end is that for the both of us to be happy, because when we're happy, then it'll come through into the music. And I think, you know, the people have to listen to it and then make up their own minds.
¿A usted, Montserrat, le preocupaba algo?
Estar dentro de la música, no, pero sí me preocupaba poder interpretar bien su música, hacerla de una forma verdadera, sentida, y sobre todo de una forma que las dos voces juntas pudieran mezclar bien y al mismo tiempo tener la expresión, porque cuando, por ejemplo, él tuvo la gentileza, you have the gentleness, de dedicar este primer cosa que hemos hecho y titularlo Barcelona, y hacer unas lyrics, unas palabras muy bellas de nuestro primer encuentro y de la Barcelona que se abre al mundo e invitar a todo el mundo a que venga. Yo le estoy profundamente agradecida, Freddy, really, que ha hecho este homenaje a la ciudad en la cual yo he nacido, y también he encontrado que los versos que empiezan con una gran suavidad y armonía, a medida que el canto procede, tienen una gran fuerza y una gran expresión y terminan con un clímax muy entusiasta y out of this world, like they say.
Freddy, would you like this song to become the official song for the Olympic Games in Barcelona in 92?
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Really? Thank you!
Yes.
That's wonderful.
I hope they take it. But if they don't like this one, I'll write another one for them. But I mean, you can't go much stronger than just saying Barcelona. I mean, it tells you everything, doesn't it? I mean, it's sort of right there. So, well, I hope the people in Barcelona, or in fact, everybody, I hope they like it.
¿Qué le parece, Montserrat, la presentación aquí en Ibiza en vez de en Barcelona, la presentación oficial?
Me parece muy bello porque han sabido escoger el lugar apropiado, tal vez, porque indudablemente el mar es nuestro mar y también El aire es nuestro aire, por lo tanto, esta zona mediterránea nos trae tantos recuerdos de todo el litoral catalán. Por lo tanto, a mí me parece una maravilla haber escogido este lugar y al mismo tiempo porque tiene un gran encanto y una gran atracción indudablemente de todo lo que procede al Barcelona canto, a nuestro canto a Barcelona.
I just asked Montserrat what she thought about doing it here. I mean, this official opening of the song in the city of Barcelona. What do you think?
Oh, well, I mean, it to me, it doesn't matter. I mean, you have to start somewhere. I mean, we can go and do it in Barcelona, we can do it everywhere, but I think there's got to be a starting point somewhere. So I think, because in the end, the song's got to be heard by everybody. It doesn't mean that just because we're starting here, that these are the only people that are going to hear it. I think, in the end, it's for the whole world, you know, so I mean, they're all going to listen to it, but we've got to start somewhere, so I don't mind.
What is the next step in your career, Freddy?
Some more songs with Monty. She's going to take up all my time now, I tell you. So, and I'm quite prepared to do it, you know, so I'm looking forward to all that time.
Montserrat, este escenario aquí en Ibiza con la gente joven y este tipo de música que se oye aquí no es mucho con lo que usted está acostumbrada a cantar. ¿Cree usted que esto servirá para acercar un poco el canto, el bel canto a la gente joven?
Indudablemente, la gente joven ya viene mucho a la ópera, indudablemente. Y al mismo tiempo, yo creo que este approach entre las dos voces y entre la música hace factible ello, porque Freddy ha hecho una música en la cual la voz de soprano se mantiene en una línea, casi diría, de bel canto y rossiniana en ciertos aspectos, logrando un mixture que es algo impresionante. Nunca se ha experimentado antes una cosa así. I think it's the first time they experimented something like that.
I think
really,
so, yeah.
Opera
yeah.
and rock together, and
especially
I love
like
it. I love it.
Yeah, especially the two voices, because it's quite unique to have two voices like that. I mean, I'm sure it's like Dinah Ross has done it with one, but from complete pure opera to like rock and roll, two very different sides. It's very difficult, and, and for the voices to match. And I think, well, I think we've done it.
Bueno, no se vayan ahora porque les van a entregar ahora a continuación una carabela de plata que es una reproducción de la Santa María con respecto al aniversario del descubrimiento. Don't go now because they are going to offer you now a silver ship which is the reproduction of the Santa María, you know, in name of the quinquennial anniversary from the discovery of America.
Good. Thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you.
Es un honor para
Oh, look at that. It's wonderful.
Oh,
really? Could you imagine?
Very nice. Thank you.
Ooh. It's nice, ne?
Beautiful.
It's bellissimo. Muchas gracias. Very beautiful, indeed.
It's also.
Es una reproducción de la Santa María.
Está inspirada. En los planos del que ha sido el gran investigador de la Santa María. Sí, es que yo
Está
mi inglés
es This mal. Is had inspiration in who?
Los planos del profesor Martínez Hidalgo.
The plans of the professor Martínez Hidalgo, which was
fue director del Museo Marítimo de
it
Barcelona.
It was the director of the Museo Marítimo in Barcelona and after his plans he has done.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah.